Hey folks, this is Best in Slot, and I am incredibly excited to bring to you tonight, Deathground. This is an upcoming dinosaur survival horror game. The game I've been waiting for years and years and years. I'm going to show you a trailer, and then we're going to discuss it. Pretty cool, right? Now that is all pre-alpha, some things might improve, some of the dinosaur assets are a little bit low res at times, blah 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 blah, but you know, 2 years until the game actually comes out. Speaking of which, Deathground is currently on Kickstarter. I'm gonna link it down below in the description. I have already backed it myself. I am very excited about this one. It is worth noting, Kickstarter is always a little bit of a risk. There's no guarantee the game will ever come out or you'll get a return on your money. But it's a very professional team. There's some people working on this game who've worked on like Alien Isolation and games like that. So that's all really, really exciting. They are a professional dev team. So I'm pretty confident. And you know, we've got a lot of cool stuff to look at tonight already. So we're going to show you a ton of information. We're going to break down what the game actually is. And you know, it's up to you guys whether you want to go support it or not. Let's get started. So what is Deathground itself? Deathground is a solo and co-op survival horror game. Oh, those words just make me so happy. With AI dinosaurs and a desperate battle for survival. You can play with up to 3 players or you can play alone in a solo session. The game does seem to be co-op or completely solo. I'm hoping the balance there is pretty good because I think it's important that the solo experience is great. Because we kind of want that terrifying solo horror experience. The game is, we'll talk a little bit more about the gameplay loops later on, but it's a little bit Left 4 Dead-esque in that you drop into an environment and you've got to get from point A to point B to point C, as it happens in this game. Let's talk about the fundamental pillars that make up the game. The first one is terror! Darkened, anxious environments overrun by deadly AI dinosaurs creates a menacing atmosphere filled with fear, suspense, and anticipation. So, great sign. The very first fundamental tenant off this game is horror. When's the last time we had that for a dinosaur game? Like 1999 with Dino Crisis? I don't think we've had a proper big budget horror dinosaur game in those 21 years since Dino Crisis came out. So this is really, really exciting. Teamwork. Next up, with constant mortal danger at every turn, teammates are put through the ultimate test of cooperation and communication as their only means of survival. So you are going to have to work as a team if you're going to play online, like I said, with up to 3 people total, so up to 2 teammates. I am hopeful that this is well balanced. I really want to be able to enjoy this as a solo player and kind of get that Alien Isolation horror dinosaur experience. So I'm hoping once a teammate is great and provides a different experience, that the solo experience isn't left behind in the meantime. And finally, we have emergence. Dynamic and reactive AI dinosaurs, dynamic objectives, as in, so sometimes you're going to spawn at different places, sometimes the loot you have to go get is at a different place, sometimes the extraction points, you saw those in the videos with the flare and the helicopters, sometimes they'll be in different locations as well. and weather changes create varied and unpredictable gameplay, which drives a tailored horror experience. Just ram it home, baby. I love it. But yeah, dinosaurs will probably spawn randomly in different locations. Some of them will be set, I'm sure. If you just think about Left 4 Dead, but with a little bit more randomness, so it's less A to B every single time, it sounds really cool. Like, it's going to launch with a fairly limited map set. I think it's 3. We're going to look at that later on. But in order to make those maps more exciting, if you have varied spawns and varied extraction points, it should do a lot to make each gameplay playthrough feel more exciting. So those are the fundamental pillars. Let's look at the myriad reasons to play the game. I know this reads a little bit like an advertisement. I don't really have any information beyond the Kickstarter, so it's going to, but I'm just excited. I can't help it for this one. It's really cool. So, squad-based survival horror, as they say, teamwork and cooperation are essential, but it does also go on to say that solo play is important as well. The atmosphere is deeper and the horror intensifies as you attempt to survive alone, so I'm really hoping there has been a lot of attention paid to how well the solo play is going to work. And look at this, look at the... it's straight out of Alien, I love it, the bloody... motion tracker. Oh, it's so good. Intense and suspenseful gameplay. Dynamic gameplay enriched with objectives, stealth, combat, and teamwork. Players will interact with a range of items and weapons and have access to a crafting system, which is actually interesting. Most of the games of this ilk don't really go in for crafting and stuff like that. We're going to take a look at a couple of screenshots, and then we're going to look at more reasons to play, blah, 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 blah. This is actually one of the more exciting screenshots in the entire thing. I do apologize for the low quality. I've blown these up to 1920, 1080, but the ones provided on the Kickstarter are, like, super small, unfortunately, so this is all I've got to work with right now. But this, A, it looks like a scene out of The Lost World Jurassic Park when the raptors fall off the roof, but B, it's really cool that the dinosaurs are seemingly fighting. You know, I don't want to walk around and have kind of like the Spinosaurus in Jurassic Park 3. I don't want to feel like I'm being hunted by these evil monster dinosaurs. I want them to be alive, natural creatures. And that means they're going to fight each other. They're going to run into each other. They're going to play with each other, blah, blah, blah. Stuff like that. Little behaviors like that should make it more interesting. Maybe there's a way to make the raptors fight. Maybe you can, you know, chuck a piece of meat in there or something, because I know there are throwable objects, and the raptors kind of fight over it, and that's an opportunity to sneak past and get to the next location. Stuff like that would be really cool, and really cool emergent gameplay. I'm going to say cool a lot today, I think. Just a little look at a much cleaner sort of indoor environment. The raptors are very Jurassic Park, original Jurassic Park in their styling. Actually, this screen right here screams Jurassic Park to me, with the dark metals and that kind of sciencey environment and the raptor design. Obviously, like I say, the raptors look a little bit weird in some angles, but you know, it is pre-alpha. We're 2 years away from full-time release, so I'd expect the assets to get a little work in the meantime. More reasons to play. Unpredictable AI dinosaurs, dynamic and reactive dinosaurs that hunt you down, influence decision-making and drive a tailored experience. So each go-through should hopefully feel at least a little bit different. There are special character classes. There's a character class system with special traits, skills, and tools. Orthogonal player-created traits mean players must choose how they'll work together in order to survive. If you're like me and you didn't know what orthogonal meant in this context, it means statistically independent. So the player character traits are statistically independent from each other. I don't know what they're going for there. Truly terrifying and diverse environments. Experience pure fear and an anxious atmosphere that put the player's survival instincts to the test. We'll harness the power of Unreal Engine 4 to create realistic and diverse environments. That's really the part of the game that looks best already. Like, some of the things, like I say, probably need upping a little bit, but the environments are beautiful and terrifying in equal measure, which is precisely what I want from a dinosaur game. We've got a couple more screenshots here. Yep, a little bit of an outside shot. Bear in mind, these are lower res than they necessarily should be. But that's going to be so... imagine just stalking through there, and you know, you're getting hunted by raptors, and you're all alone, and... oh. I've got to stop. I sound like I'm doing an advertisement, and I promise that isn't my goal. I want people to be objective and critical and think about if they're going to spend their money on this product. I'm just saying that I myself am very excited about this. Reasons to play more, so replayable gameplay, as we mentioned, random spawn and extraction points, dynamic objectives as you go through, hopefully. So let's say, we're going to go into this in a little bit, but the basic gameplay loop is you land at different points, seemingly. You have to go get some high value loot, also probably at different points, and then you have to escape, again, from different points. And hopefully we're going to get other dynamic objectives throughout. So maybe one time you go through and a gate will be locked and you have to find the button for it, maybe another time an alarm will go off, maybe another time there'll be a flood, blah, 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 I don't know, but just random things will happen that kind of impede you and require you to do different things as you go through the level. We have an original soundtrack, very cool, and community-driven development. Death Ground is a game developed by passionate dinosaur and horror fans. The community will have an active role in helping to shape the game experience so together we can create something incredible. There'll be testing during phases of development if the tier's been purchased. Like I said, I think it's the £50 tier is the minimum one you need to hit to get access to like the earliest available testing that is going to go out to Kickstarter backers. And there'll be an emphasis on player feedback. We'll host a platform for the community to stay actively involved with the development team. So, this is the gameplay loop I mentioned. So, if we start in the top left, enter play session at spawn point. You go in, you get the loot, you get to the extraction point, you get out alive, and you level up. So, it's kind of like, I haven't played much of it, but it's like Vermintide a little bit. Less so Left 4 Dead. So, in Left 4 Dead, every time you started the game, you played with the exact same characters, and those characters didn't develop. You know, there wasn't an XP system, you did level up, but it didn't unlock you new things. At least last time I played Left 4 Dead, it didn't. Vermintide, you can unlock new loot and stuff like that as you went through, and that gave you access to sort of higher tier difficulties. It does create a slightly imbalanced playing field, you know, if not everyone goes in with the exact same loot every single time. It does mean sometimes you'll be outgeared by your teammates, but as long as cooperation is the focus, or indeed if you're playing solo, that matters a lot less. But the idea is you go in, you complete a level, you'll get experience, you'll level up, maybe you'll be able to pick different traits, pick new equipment, stuff like that. So that should keep it a little bit more interesting as well, and give you more of a reason to go back in. I am 50-50 on that because I like that aspect of it, but I do think these kind of games, especially online co-op games, really benefit from having level playing fields. But maybe certain difficulties will be locked behind certain item levels and stuff like that, and that should ensure more of an even field. We'll have to see how that works out. I don't want to comment on it too much when we don't know what's going on. Each map will contain, so this is the crafting system, each map will contain many items that can be picked up and used in order to survive. Some can be combined and crafted into other objects. The game will be balanced in a way where survival horror aspects are enhanced, so bullets are going to be rare, and creating noise will have consequences. Distraction and outthinking the deadly dinosaurs that roam the map is crucial to surviving. And that sounds great. If I bring it back to Left 4 Dead again, Left 4 Dead was very go, 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 run and gun, action, action, action. And I think most of these games usually are. If we compare this also to, you know what, I can't even remember its name, but there's one coming out for the Xbox Series X and for the PS5, that dinosaur, next-gen dinosaur game I highlighted a couple months ago. That was very run and gun and blow everyone up. Because I think these online co-op goal games tend to be. It's quite hard to have a stealth co-op group experience in some ways. I'm really glad they're trying to push that though with the the motion tracker just makes me so happy. With the motion trackers and stuff like that, you know, trying to group up to survive and co-op sneak through the levels sounds really exciting. And, you know, one of your teammates screws up and makes a bunch of noise, and suddenly the entire group is panicked and sprinting, and it's going to create some really cool dynamic emergent gameplay. So these are some of the planned dinosaurs. This is where it gets a little bit finicky. I'm going to talk about this more in a little bit. So just remember T-Rex, Allosaurus, Velociraptor, Compi. They're clearly not going for an all-out, overly realistic interpretation of the dinosaurs. You know, that's very much not the goal. The T-Rex has shades of Turok about it to me, but a couple more screenshots here. There's a look at the Rex, and it's a good looking Rex. It definitely doesn't have the over the top mutated look that other game had. I really can't remember what it's called. It looks great. You know, it's not, yes, it's not a Saurian Rex or whatever, but it looks good. It looks believable, and if that comes at me in the middle of the night, I will be sufficiently terrified, and that's what I want. Likewise with the Raptors, it looks really cool there. It looks a little bit like the poster for Spider-Man 3 there. Maybe that's a sign somehow. But yeah, they look good. They do. And it, you know what's important? I think, and it's probably partly on purpose, they do look Jurassic Park-esque. And I think what we've wanted for a long time is Jurassic Park meets Alien Isolation, and we're going to get something like that, and that's really cool. So we're going to take a little look at some of the available classes. There are three to look at. I think that's how many we're spawning with. So basically, they've all got different stats. Maybe that's strength and inventory size, stamina, throw distance, tiptoes, I assume your sneaking ability, and your sprint speed. So each class is going to be good in general at different things. But then they're also going to have unique abilities. So the engineer can hack systems like doors, alarms, and power grids. Now, the impression I got from reading the Kickstarter is that you are going to pick your class, go online, and match with other players, assuming you want to play co-op. And given that there's three classes, I think at the moment you basically get matched with the other two classes. So maybe you lose your engineer halfway through, and then you're trying to get through a door, you're going to have to go find some tools. But if your engineer's there and helpful, he can get through without having to find like hacking kits and stuff like that. There's also the scout, who is the only one with the motion tracker. So the Scout is going to be, I think, very, very popular. I'm already leaning in a Scout direction myself. And there's also the Hunter, lets you sense your surroundings, and they carry a high-caliber rifle. Very Muldoon look in there, which is very cool. Got a little look here at some of the environments. And a little cheeky little sauropods there. Don't think we'll be killing any sauropods. Don't think they're necessarily going to be in the game, but it'd be cool if they were atmospheric dinosaurs, you know? Anyways, yeah, just a little glimpse. We've got these, like, hilltop science labs. We've got these sort of, you know, misty, ruined jungles as well. Very cool. And a couple of the actual in-game shots. Again, low res, but looks beautiful. Imagine creeping through there. You know, one of you's got a motion tracker. You're all scanning the tree line. You hear rustling and there's raptors about. It's going to be so cool. I think I got one more. No, so what is the long-term vision? And there's a couple of things here I want to mention. So the idea is to develop DevGround with the community for the long haul. We want to grow the game over time, adding more features, content, and game modes as we go. So that could be new dinosaurs, new player abilities, new maps and zones, ranked seasons, which would be really cool, and different game modes that move the base survival horror formula off access and could include more PvP aspects. Less interesting for me, but the other stuff makes a lot of sense. You know, add more dinosaurs, add more guns, add more classes, add more maps. Really, my only negative for this entire thing comes on this next page. So this is the idea for the base game. Solo and co-op for 1-3 players. It's releasing on Steam on the PC, by the way. There's no console release mentioned, although I imagine one of these stretch goals in the bottom left is probably a console release, if I had to guess. 3 character classes, which is absolutely fine. 2 dinosaur types, and that's what's bugging me a little bit. Only a raptor and a T-Rex at release. Now, again, I'm going to assume one of the goals is maybe Compsognathus, Allosaurus, but that's why I mentioned this earlier when I was showing you the dinosaur page, this one right here. It shows 4, but only 2 of those are actually planned to be in the game. Given the game is 2 years away and is going to release on Steam, it's a viable game, blah blah blah, I would expect more than that. I don't think 2 is enough. I think you need 4 to 5, realistically. You know, raptors would be your base enemy, and then the others would kind of like, I don't want to keep harping on about it, but kind of like Left 4 Dead. You've got your base zombies, you've got your base raptors, and then every now and again a T-Rex pops up, or a swarm of compies, or a Dilophosaurus, or something like that. Just something to mix up the content a little bit. I'm really hopeful that changes, and it isn't reliant on goals, because I think it's just by default, we should have more dinosaurs than that. 3 maps is okay, but kind of the same thing. I'd expect more like 5 or so, personally. But the crafting system, P2P and networking, everything else looks great. Those are my only hesitations. They really are. And by the looks of how well the Kickstarter's doing, it is going to smash the initial goal. So we should start to see these future goals, blah, blah, blah. Assuming the Kickstarter does really well, we'll probably be back in a few weeks. And I'll, you know, we'll go through what the unlocked goals are and maybe talk about those as well. But that's it, folks. That's DevGround. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. I personally am pretty bloody excited. It is, in many, many ways, the game I've been waiting for such a long time. It just is. I don't want to hype it up too much when the game is 2 years away. And at the end of the day, it's a Kickstarter project. They don't always work out, but there's a lot to look forward to, from my perspective. There's a lot here that's really cool. There's a lot here that is very much speaking to exactly what we have wanted for a long time as a dinosaur gaming community. So hopefully it all works out. Like I said, I'll link that Kickstarter down below if you want to give it a go for yourselves. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers much love as always. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this video and you're excited about the game. Should remember to do that. I'm a good YouTuber. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much love as always. Bye-bye.